Okay, for a particular engine, suppose we have an engine. How many types of liquids we require for cooling? Oil, basic purpose is what?
Lubrication.
So we will not consider oil as a cooling medium. It is doing some amount of cooling, but let's not consider that right now as a cooling medium. Cooling medium for what we require?
Jacket.
Jacket water at what temperature is going?
35.
Sorry?
45.
Basically, we control the outlet at around 80-85, we try to keep it. So, inlet is around 65 to 72. Jacket water. Okay? Why don't we, and for what we require cooling? What else? Air cooler, not turbocharger. Turbocharger is cooled by lube oil. So, one is air cooler. Then for what we require?
Liner
is cooled by whom? Jacket. So that we already wrote. What else is required? Okay, look for to cool lube oil cooler. Correct? That is cooled by whom? Sea water. So why we are not cooling jacket with jacket with sea water side? Okay, so why we don't use, what I'm saying is, why don't we use jacket water here to cool air cooler and lube oil cooler? No, but if you supply at less temperature, we can do, no? Why we don't do? Okay, what temperature sea water is? 28 to? 32. Let's assume it is be less also, but let's assume it is 28 to 32. Suppose if we supply 28 to 32 degrees here, what will happen? Thermal efficiency will reduce. It will start thermal cracking might take place. Thermal stresses will come. More important is thermal efficiency goes down. So that's why for an engine we require two types of liquids. One is high temperature. One is low temperature. Earlier, for low temperature, we used to use sea water. Now we are using, and for high temperature, we used to use jacket water or fresh water. So basically, what used to happen? Your jacket water was doing the cooling, and that was all again cooled by sea water. And this was called jacket water cooler. Then sea water was also cooling your air cooler, lube oil cooler, and refrigeration, AC. Correct?
Yes.
This part you all understood?
Yes, sir.
Now with sea water, what happens? What are the disadvantages? Is
corrosion.
And also? Sorry? Marine growth. So these things are not just affecting cooler, it is affecting coolers, pipes, filters, everywhere. So because of that, what we have come up with a system called central cooling. So there what we have, here we had only one fresh water. Understood? Which we used to call jacket water. Now we have another water called LT. Then we have jacket which was there is now called HT. And your LT is cooled by sea water. Correct? Now when I showed here, earlier when I showed here, I showed it as a closed loop. basically, actually normally it will go from in to out, overboard will go, but then you have a provision to do recirculation. Understood? In cold countries you can do recirculation. You will not do entirely, but part of it will recirculate. In the same way, now HT is what? Basically jacket water only. So where HT is cooled by LT, that is called HT cooler. Then where LT is cooled by sea water, that is called LT cooler or central freshwater cooler. Understood? Again, here also you have, sorry, in and out, and again you have a recirculation line. Then for this you have pumps. Mostly you will have three pumps. Sometimes you will have two. If you have three, you will have one small pump known as harbor pump. Understood? Then for LT also, to recirculate LT. Now for jacket water here for jacket water you had jacket water pumps, correct? You had two sets. For here also you are having what it is called HT pumps. For LT you are having again three pumps, and then again one will be called harbor LT pump. Why basically it is called harbor? Because it is a small capacity pump to be used only during port stay or anchorage. Understood? Because the capacity of the pump is less, as the requirement of the cooling is also less. Now earlier I was telling you all about, I told you all about this, correct? We require two types of liquids, so that has been satisfied here. Now here what will happen, as for jacket water earlier is to have expansion tank. For both you might have separate expansion tank. Understood? Sometimes on some diagrams, why I'm telling all is because this, all these things you'll see in your line diagrams. For some line diagrams, what is there, like suppose this is a generator engine, only one will be supplied. Okay, here LT temperature is around, maintained around 25 to 35 degrees. Understood? This temperature will be maintained. HT is same, again inlet is around 65 to 72. Now for generator engine I was telling all, only LT will be passed, then it will go for your air cooler and lube oil cooler. Then one will be passed for jacket. So what will happen is, for jacket you are having this pump here, jacket attached pump. One line will be given back, and here you will have your TCV, temperature control valve. So what will happen is, when this will not give water back, this line, there will be no water going, all water will be returning back to inlet till the temperature comes up. Understood? Then there will be another line which will go and meet other generators. Now what will happen, suppose this number one generator, number one and number two is stop condition and number three is running. Now the attached pump of this, after the attached pump, this is high pressure side, everyone agrees, and this is a low pressure side, agreed? So what will happen, this line which will be pressurized compared to the other two generators which are not running, because the attached pump is not running. So water will start flowing to those generators, and that will keep the generator slightly warm. Normally for main engine what happens, we have another steam heater to keep the engine warm during when the engine is not running. So here what will happen, it will be supplying water, In case if number 3 is not running, if number 1 is running, then the water flow will be opposite. Also there will be another line which will go to your vent or your expansion tank. Understood? This which is there will not be there on every ship. Understood? Now you'll understood LTHT difference. Only thing is you are having more pumps. LT pumps are added and you will have LTO central freshwater coolers. Again here LT will be cooling everything on ship. Sea water is only going to the LT cooler and going out. Sea water will only go to LT cooler and go out. Understood? It is not going anywhere else. And also for your freshwater generator, evaporator side. Sometimes it will go for your cooler also, condenser also. But many a ships, condenser you might have LT going, and for only for evaporator you will have seawater going. Understood? Okay. Go. Any doubts I have?
So in central cooling there is one more.
No, you will only have for sea water side, because the water just to protect your LT coolers. Understood? You will have, but only thing that anode consumption will not be that much high. Anything else? Okay. Just do these lines which I told you, try to find these lines. Do all the lines, only then you will understand what I am telling you.